Hey everybody, Chris here, and welcome to my pick of the week for March 19, 2014. And my pick of the week, guys, is Daredevil issue number 1. A perfect jumping on point for new readers. A awesome continuation of Mark Waid and Chris Samnee's series. And just great. It introduces you, if you guys did not read, like myself, the Marvel Infinite Daredevil, where it explains the whole move from New York to San Francisco. You jump right into San Francisco, and you get Matt Murdock working in a police office, trying to solve where this missing person is. He Daredevils out, and you get a big old summary of everything that basically made Daredevil Daredevil. You also get a little bit of a summary of what, you get to see New York. The artwork's really good. You get a little bit of a sum up of what went on before this. Not too much, though. So, once again, if you did not read the previous volume of Daredevil, like, you won't know who Kristen McDuff is, or McDuffie? I want to make sure I got her name right. Next page. Beat it. I love when pages stick together. McDuffie, I was right. So Kristen is working with Daredevil because Daredevil knows New York like the back of his hand, but San Francisco, not so much. So basically, she's his Google map, so to speak, while he's swinging around the city. He saves this little girl, and they're being chased by these glider people, and he doesn't know why. Then he figures out that the little girl, spoiler alert, has a bomb inside of her, and they want him to take her to a public area like a police station or somewhere, so this way they can set off the bomb inside of her and just hurt a huge amount of people. So Daredevil instead finds a elevator, which basically blocks all radio signal, which is nice. It's definitely a smart read. So Daredevil keeps her hidden, takes out the guy, saves the girl, and that's how it is. And then you kind of get a little bit of a weird ending where you have Matt kind of saying... he was working with a man named Foggy, and then in the end you just see a video of Foggy watching, and he's like, was? I'm still here. And it's kind of left in the dark. At first I did not realize that the bald-headed person was Foggy at the end. I thought that it was somebody completely different, and then it was actually pointed out to me during the live show that is Foggy, and I was like, oh yeah. But really, this is just an introduction. This is not something that plays into a major thing yet. The last page is kind of a continuation, like, it's going to continue forward from the last page. But from page one all the way through to the page right before the last two pages, it's just an introduction of Daredevil now being in San Francisco, both as Matt Murdock and as Daredevil. And it just reintroduces Daredevil to you. It kicks off a brand new volume. Does it explain what happened in the last volume? No. So I would highly recommend you still check out the previous volume of Daredevil, where Mark Waid actually started on Daredevil. It was a spectacular run. It was a spectacular volume. The one thing I do not like that they did with Daredevil is they added a bonus digital copy and bumped up the price an extra dollar. So instead of being $2.99, now that Marvel knows Daredevil is gold, they are now charging everybody $3.99 per Daredevil issue. So basically, they're like, hey, we're going to charge you an extra dollar, but don't worry, you get a free bonus digital copy as well. I don't want a bonus digital copy of Marvel. Keep your bonus digital copies, and you can take them and you know what you can do with them. Take them off the books and give us back our $2.99 price tag on a lot of the books that you brought up to $3.99 just because they have a bonus digital copy. If you have a physical copy, 2-to-1, it's because you don't want the digital copies to begin with. I was sitting there thinking about this a couple of days ago. I'm like, wait a minute. Most people who buy the physical copies because they don't want to buy the digital copies. So what's the point of getting a free digital copy if you have a hard copy? Oh, so if you go on the road, you don't have to take your books with you. You take your little iPod out and read your book. Please. If I go on a trip and I don't take my books with me, or if I have to pick some books to take me, I'll take the physical copies. Keep your bonus copy. I don't need no explanation. I don't need nothing. You keep your book. You keep your free digital book because you erased all my free digital books I had on your website anyway already. Keep your digital books because your website screwed up anyway. But looking over all that bullshit, this is a 5 out of 5-star book this week. Loved it. Cannot recommend it highly enough to anybody, even though it is a dollar more now. Mark Waid, Chris Samnee, worth every single penny. And that's it for this review, guys. So don't forget to check out comic-related and comicfrontline.com. Together we're your number one source for comic-related news, reviews, and a whole bunch more. If you haven't already subscribed to Comic Frontline, please do. This way we are in your sub box and you don't miss out on a single video we have coming up, coming out, or going on in the near to distant future. So until next time, everybody, take care, keep reading, keep collecting, and I will see you guys in the next review.